Welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we are going to talk about this cage style ring and what is the most easy way to construct them. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start build this ring at the front view. Let's bring in a circle for diameter 16 millimeter. Then we're gonna coming into the side view. And the side view, what we wanted to do is draw an arc. Let's draw something like this for somewhere about this size, which is pretty wide for a ring already, for the bottom of a ring shank. And we want to use a line to connect it these two points and make sure you join them, right? To make it nice and rounded, we want to fit at the corner. Let me type it 0.5 to see how does it look. All right, it look all right there. Okay, now once we have this, this is constructing by multiple curve, and we don't want that. We want it to be a single curve. This is super important. You have to rebuild right here, and let's put it into 15 and click, make sure the degree equal 3, and then we click OK. Now, once you have this, the bottom look irregular there. To make it completely flat, we can choose all the point and type it command set point, and we want to align to the Z axis, so it will follow our mouse, and I just want to snapping into the quadrant. So now we have one there. Mirror that profile, and that's holding the shift, so I will copy one to the bottom. Since I'm going to make it into the dome ring, I would like to have this one to be 3D scale. And I want to use 3D scale tool because I want to set the center here instead of using gumball. Okay, so let's move it up a little bit, roughly like this. Okay, if you feel like you need to be wider, you can use the gumball to stretch it, but I'm going to stop it right here. Create a surface. We can use a sweep one rail, and we're going to pick up the rail cross section. And make sure that this is coming into the center. I always like to align into inside of a ring shank, so the seam won't be on the side. And then we want to close the sweep. Before we click OK there, we want to look at the wireframe and see if that is what you want. Pretty much it is equally all the way until it close to the top. Right, so we might need to adjust a little bit on the top, but it look nice. You can also try rebuild within certain point that may not 100% follow your profile though, because your profile is with rebuild within the last point that the profile has. Okay, so I'm going to stick with the don't change cross section, and I'm gonna click OK. Let's move it to the other layer, and in this layer I'm going to temporarily hide this one. We're going to offset this guy for 0.3 millimeter, because I'm going to pipe it later on for 0.6 millimeter. Once you have it, this since it is an offset, it has a lot of point. We want to rebuild one more time and to have a last point but not changing too much. So the same with the 15 point there. And then if you don't like the button, again, the buttons kind of bother you, you want to pick up all the button, type a set point, and then align to the Z somewhere there, so that button will be nicer. We're gonna do one more time, rebuild this guy, and then to be 15, pick up all the top there, set point, and align to the Z. And you can adjust the shape a little bit if you like it. If it is, doesn't look puffy as a shape that you want, you can just edit the control point. For example, I think they might be too pointed, and I'm going to drag it back. All right, we are going to creating another ring inside of that ring. So let's go ahead to use a sweep tool, sweep one rail. You got rail, cross section, and cross section. Make sure you align to the center again. Once we got that, we want to close the sweep and we want to click OK. All right, so this is the inside ring that we have. We actually don't need the button, so I'm going to draw a line there from the center, and then long enough to cross the whole ring, and then we're just gonna go ahead to trim the button off. So we just need the top part, right? So once the top part is there, we're gonna pick up those two surfaces, and then we're gonna come into the curve from the object. We have extract wireframe. Now Once you have the wireframe, you're going to see the wire like this. We want to go to the front view and take a look at the front view. Maybe this is the extra, this is the extra, and then so everything else is evened out. We're also gonna look at the right view and see if it is too many wires there. So I'm going to delete some of them. This look pretty even out, but the one in the middle, I do need to have a curving. But so I'm gonna bring back the surface, and then we are going to extract ISO curve from this surface. And we wanna make sure that we're snapping in the middle there. So that way we can delete this one and this one. We're gonna extract ISO curve again and make sure that you're snapping into the same place. So now this is our wire, and see if that is what you like. Also on the bottom, we might have too many wires, so I want to delete the one inside as well. So double check on the look and see if that is what you want, and we can go ahead to pipe it. Again, initially we want to pipe it 4.6 millimeter in diameter, so I'm just gonna type it 0.3 here. Alright, so this will be our structure. Now I want to turn it on the first ring shank that we did, and I want to trim it off the top. So let's go ahead to make a line again, and we're gonna pick up this one and trim everything on the top. And don't forget to cap this one. Now we can turn on this, and they will match really nicely because that 0.3 there. If it is bother you on this edges, you can also give it a fitted edges, so that will look much nicer, and you can set the stone right in between. My next goal for the channel is to reach 30,000 subscribers so I can open the membership function. That may help to release my other duties and able to create more videos and show more tips and tricks for the paying member. So please ask all your friends, subscribe to PJ Chen Design's channel. Thank you, and I will see you next.